Hi, we're back for part B of the first week, and coming to you live from Rogue Valley, sort of live, putting on tape. And this part is going to be patterns, and we're going to start with very basic patterns. And in fact, matter of fact, we're using a pattern from Alex Krebs. He has a phone app that you can get, Alex Krebs Tango, and there's, I think, 6 or 7 videos, and he has one just on Milonga. And I'm just going to call it Alex Basic, 4-count basic. It's a little bit unusual. So let's start with that. We'll demonstrate it together a couple times, then we'll break it apart, and then we'll do it to music.
I want to say one thing, and that is that what we really liked about this whole sequence of classes, the 6 classes, is that Clay designed all of the movements you're going to learn starting from this basic. So you'll always enter every movement that we teach, every combination, from this beginning basic. So it's a really good thing to get under your in your body, because we're going to use it a lot.
Okay, so demonstrating it, it is 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now we, let me just go through it again one slowly. So 1, 2, and most of you are going to find it easier to do a side together here. Alex does not, it's not that one's right or one's wrong. You might try it both ways, out and side together. So let's talk about the leads part and the follows part separately. So the first part is starting with the right foot, which is a little bit unusual for you. Going forward, I'm stepping outside, so notice the contrabody motion to be able to step outside. That's 1, and then 2 is more or less straight ahead, and then 3 and 4, you have an option of going together, together, 1, 2, together, together, 1, 2, or outside, forward, and side together, outside, forward, and side together.
Notice how important it is that Clay brings his second step forward back into the center line of dance. If you don't come back forward, you're gonna end up moving into the inner side and inner part of your dance floor. So you have to come back to a straight step.
Okay, follower's part?
Follower's step is gonna be, of course, the opposite of what the lead is doing. I'm going to step back first with my right foot. I'm touching my left, saying right. My left foot, and I'm going to do a little bit of a cross behind myself because he's leading me, he's stepping outside. So I'm going to step back a little bit outside, and then again straight because he's bringing me back into the line of dance, and then into a collect position. So again, notice my contra body also. 1, 2, 3, 4. Back, back, together, together. Back, back, together, together. Back, back, together, together.
Okay, so we'll do some with music. You can practice right along, solo or with a partner if you have one.
We'll probably do it both in close and in open breaks. It's really good practice just to go as Clay did, close on the closing beats and also a sidestep. It really tests your lead and follow just on something simple like that.
Okay, the next part of it, Alex, I think, calls it a turn. We're calling it Alex's 4-count basic with I call it a come around. That comes from, what's the dance? A different swing dance, Balboa actually, come around. So let's demonstrate it. First of all, it's a little turning step. So it starts exactly the same. One, two, three, four. Notice that I'm turning clockwise. One, two, three, four.
Follows. Notice that you're the center of the circle and lead. You have to take a bigger step to get around me.
Okay, lead's part's very simple. It steps outside as before, and now instead of going straight down the line of dance, I turn my body to the right and step to the side and together. Four. One, two, three. One, two, three, four. The follower's part.
And notice that my steps are much smaller because I'm in the center of the circle. I don't have as far to go. So I'm just going to basically stay in the center. Back, it's almost a together. I have a very tiny side step because I'm the center of the circle.
Okay, let's do that to music. You can practice with us. So now we're going to put the music back on. We're going to do half a song or a little bit more. Did you want to try leading it or not?
Oh, you mean just right here?
No, I mean after, when we put the music on.
Yeah, I'll try it.
Okay, so we'll do a half a song and then we'll switch maybe from lead and follow, which is always good. We're going to do those two patterns plus some of the stuff we had in part A of this, which is marking time and maybe some slow checks, whatever we feel like doing.
Okay, I'm nervous now, all of you inexperienced leaders, because I'm going to be put on the spot, but so got to have fun with it, right?
Cuando tú pasas caminando por las tardes, repiqueteando tu taquito en la vereda, marca compases de cadencia melodiosa, de una milonga con padrona y callejera, y en tus vaivenes pareciera la bailara, así te miren los que quieran, porque tú llevas en tu cuerpo una arrogancia y el majestuoso ondulante.
And you can certainly see how
An inexperienced lead can just, you know, have fun with it.
And an inexperienced follower. But it's really good practice to switch back and forth like that. Okay, so that completes the material from video 1A and 1B. Hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Have fun. Stay safe.
Stay safe.